was 12 years old, I seen a book on Tom Platz. It was something about his legs that rocked my little world, shall we say. And I took this book home and, little to my parents' knowledge, dug the weights of the shed and hid the weights in the bed and brought them out every single night and squatted it till the death.
What it's like to spend idle time pondering other nonsensical things with the effort of using our mind consciously, every day, all day, as if walking in a meditation with our thoughts fixed on the end result. And that end result is to be able to get on stage September 26th, 7th, and unveil something that is more than beautiful.
I just like to be remembered as somebody who was a great inspiration to other people, tried to educate them the best way to it, you know, through all the six videos that I made and the one book that I've written. There's tons of seminars that I've done all over the world, passed on the knowledge to them that was passed upon to me, because that's pretty much what makes the world a better place for everybody. A lot of people around the world that, you know, I could, you know, teach and show how to do it the correct way. There's a lot of other groups out there that I can join up with that can help people become better in this sport. And also some personal training organizations going on right now that's helping people in the sport and provide knowledge to people that don't know it, you know. I've been in this sport now for about 20 years, and I pretty much know just about it, everything there is to know, so I got tons and tons of knowledge to pass on to people.
Bodybuilding has become very scientific, where it's not just about lifting weights and dieting for competition. You have to sit there and plan, methodically plan out a map of what's going to tune your body into the best without just weight training and dieting. You know, you have to get the muscles to react properly. You have to get the physique to balance out as much as possible and create that illusion that you didn't have the year prior. And you can't just do that with food and training on the same schedule. It all switches up. You train more days, you train less days. You know, you do more volume training, you do less volume training, you do higher reps, lower reps. The food varies week to week, day to day. There's just so many different things that mentally you have to be prepared to say, okay, I had a plan to do this, but we're going to change it, we're going to do that. And you have to realize that you listen to your body and not listen to your mind sometimes. And that's really takes a lot of mental preparation to be able to handle those ups and downs.
life at the gym. The gym was my training ground for life. It was my life for many, many years. As I ventured out into other business activities, I thought about how did the gym work? The gym is home for me. It always has been, and I feel most comfortable when I go back home.